totally it's mine. The relationship will be restored. Yeah, willing to welcome. Willing to welcome. Oh, but there are times, of course, but there are times, even though you forgive that person, the relationship was restored, but sometimes there is some line or there are some areas or limitation to that person. That's nothing wrong. Okay, as human being, sometimes there are some limitation that you will not trust 100% anymore, but forgiveness and reconciliation was already done. Okay? And of course, probably someday, somehow, the relationship was totally reconciled everything. Everything. Okay? Because sometimes there are some areas that need healing. Time to heal. Alright, time to heal. The hurt that you experience. Of course, I understand the older brother feeling, okay, but in the following verses, in verse 28 to 32, you will see here the father's wisdom. God gave him the wisdom. Look at in verse 28. Even though his son, older son, complained, the older brother became angry and refused to go in. So his father went out and pleaded him. And he answered his father, look at these years. I've been slaving for you and never disobeyed your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat so I could celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours, who has squandered your property with prostitutes, come home, you give the father call for him. My son, the father said, you are always with me, and everything I have is yours. But we have to celebrate and be glad because this brother of yours was dead and is alive again, and he was lost and is found. What a good illustration in here. The father's wisdom, wise in his handling the pouting son. Okay? And also wise in seeking to reconcile. He explained to the older son about reconciliation. Even for sure, if you are the older son, that's the same feeling. Right? That's very normal, very common. Ang bait-bait mo, wala kang naman. You are a good son. Of course, if I am that son, the older son, I have the same feeling. For sure. But the father gave them wisdom. And that is true. Total. And even here, the older son, the father wants him to forgive his older son. A very good principle that we can learn from this passage, from the parable of the father's heart. The father's heart. So in conclusion this afternoon, and beloved in the Lord, God began the work of reconciliation. I mentioned that earlier. God began through the Lord Jesus Christ. Because we are totally separated from God. From the Garden of Eden, when Adam and Eve committed sin, we are totally separated from God. Here is the man. Here is God. But the Lord Jesus Christ, God the Father, sent His Son so that all of us could be reconciled with God. God did it already because of His great love for us and our great need for Him. All of us, no one is exempted. We are all bound to eternal punishment called hell. But God did the reconciliation. The method was costly, but the price has been paid. Sometimes it costs us something to reconcile with other people. Always look upon God for what He did for us. We can make a lot of justification about forgiving other people for reconciliation. Oh, this person, he's not talking to me. That's why I will not talk to him too.
So sometimes we...
But let's pray, let's win other people for restoration. When other people, committed or still sinning, always think of restoration. Help this person. When other people get a committed sin, sometimes our tendency, that person is to put our feet or put his head on the floor. No. The right spirit or the right practice for all the Christians. If someone committed sin, like this son, we need to embrace and to show our love for them. Always restoration. But of course, before restoration, there must be humility. The person must admit it about sin. Like this younger son, he admitted what he done. And now there is that forgiveness. That's why the father said, he easily forgiven his son, because his son is humble enough to admit what he did for them. Will you be reconciled to him and commit yourself to a ministry of reconciliation? The ministry of reconciliation. This is something lacking in many churches nowadays. The ministry of reconciliation. How much that person offended you, we must reconcile. The world certainly needs it. If God cannot find the ministry of reconciliation inside the church, how much more outside the church in this world? God is expecting to you and me to reconcile the broken relationship to God and this parable of the Father's heart. My prayer that all of us must have this Father's heart to his son. Very seldom you can find that person, the parable of the Father's heart. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you. And we praise you, O Lord, for this parable. Thank you, O God, for reminding us. So, Father God, I pray that you will bless this into our heart. The principle of forgiveness and reconciliation. Father God, I pray that you will continue to speak to our heart. I don't know your heart this afternoon. Probably someone hurt you for many weeks or months, probably years, that you are not settled to that problem. Or probably you know that you offended other person and God wants you to reconcile that person. Your fellow Christian, probably to your parents or someone in your workplace. God wants us to see our humility. You cannot do that without the grace and mercy of God. You cannot do it by yourself. You need God's mercy. You need God's grace in order for you to do it. And God's will for us is to reconcile. Second, reconcile to other people. And today, before I close this message, probably someone, you need prayer. You want to reconcile to other person or to someone. And you need courage. And you need prayer. I'm here. We can pray for one another. If that's your prayer, I will not ask you who is that person. But probably you can just say it to the Lord. And then you need prayer. Raise your hand. I pray for anyone. So anyone, thank you. Yes. God bless you. Anyone? You want to reconcile to other people or someone? Anyone? Thank you. Salamat po. Nanay. Amen. Amen. Anyone? Before I close. Before I close this message. And thank God. Thank God. Because the inner peace is there. If you know in your heart that you have no hard feeling or even bad feeling to other person, you will have peace of mind. You have joy in your heart. You cannot walk normally if you have bitterness. So thank God for those who raised their hand. Father God, thank you for your word today. A great reminder for us the father's heart, oh Lord, the parable of the father's heart. So Lord, thank you, and I pray for those who raise their hands. Have mercy with them. May your grace be upon them, oh Lord. Thank you, oh Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I will ask Father King to render a special music, a special number. Ask the Father King to render a special, just one for one, all right? The other two stars. Yeah, a challenge for us. You know what, Father?